王，大霸王来了！大霸王，大霸王来了！求求你，不要欺负我！行，给我哈哈哈哈哈，可怜的我，辛辛苦苦种来的谷，可怜的我，这个年头折磨过。王走了，哈哈哈！大霸王活该，哈哈哈！大霸王活该，哈哈哈！大霸王活该。
To this village I came, a collector to be, by the power of mighty Kublai Khan.I will do my work as quickly as I can for you, new taxes. The profits all for me. I saw your children weep, your old ones bent to implore, your villages aflame, and you, like frightened mice. How can I continue to carry out this task?How can I endure to share this awful blame? How can I accept this endless shame? I knew you would come.
Why were you challenging me like that? Your words were like a whip on my back.
Those verses are not mine. I am only an actor.
Whose were they?
A lonely poet wrote them.
Where is he?
He does not like to show himself.
Well, take me to him.
I have already told you. He wants to be left alone.
I need his help.
You need the help of a poor farmer? A conquered subject?
I need the help of an honest man. That's my uncle, Mateo.
Come, but alone, without your escort.
I ask you to accept us into your home, as friends.
You command, Yangu obeys.
I command you to stop obeying. I need your advice.
It's a tea we need.
You have crossed my threshold. Now my house is your house. By receiving you here, we are also trusting you with our lives. my daughter Miley forgets that the modesty of shadow is more befitting a young girl than light.
No, Yanku. Though all precious things love light, you know that. You're a poet. Although, the verses I heard today were dark, bitter.
Our lives are bitter.
The Khan's tax collectors are not only interested in our rice and grain, but we have to keep our women hidden from their sight too, especially if they're pretty.
We've come here to get to know you, to understand your situation. We'll talk about these tributes you're required to pay and find out what's fair.
Fair? The taxes have never been fair. Those who have little pay heavily, while those who have much hang on to their wealth.
Well, that's why we're here. We want to help.
The names, the number of the inhabitants, the amounts, all may be correct. As far as reality goes, why should you worry if a father is ill and cannot work? Or if a crop's been destroyed by hail, or a granary hit by lightning?
What do you mean?
There is a law, the Great Khan decreed. If a village or district suffer from hail or lightning, and crops are destroyed, taxes should be suspended for 3 years.
We've heard of no. Who is she?
Lai Yuan is like another daughter to me. Curiosity was too strong for her as well. But so much the better. I don't want you to think that I'm hiding anything from you.
Lai Yuan?
What I am saying is, if I confide my secret in you, you become my accomplice.
But she's not Chinese.
Lai Yuan means to have come from afar.
I think your curiosity has been satisfied. You heard the voice of our suffering, the reasons of our discontent. And you saw our humiliation. Please, remember all this as to ourselves.
You will be welcome to visit my house whenever you wish. You know the danger that hangs over us and our women. Beware. Just one careless word may destroy us.
In 2 days, we celebrate the festival of the dragon boats.
In honor of the dragons?
No. In the memory of Chu Yuan, one of our ancient poets. He was drowned in a river. Since then, our people decorate their boats in honor of him and sing, recite his poetry, throwing rice and sweets into the water for the fish to eat. So that they'll leave the poet's body untouched.
That's a beautiful tradition.
This time, the songs will be embittered by the sorrows and despairs of our people. They raided two villages along the river by the orders of the governor.
I promise. Things will change, Anzu. The men of the North will learn to respect your people and their ways.
It is easy for you to say, but to Talib and his men, we are nothing more than livestock, not free men.
Justice will come. I promise.
Do you realize that only half of what is collected here reaches Kambalik? The rest goes to the pockets of Talib and his men.
That's a dangerous accusation, unless you possess absolute proof.
The proof? It won't take very long to find it. All you have to do is verify.
No, you won't be allowed to verify anything.
Why?
The tax for those fields was 10 card loads of vegetables. It has been raised to 15. And you can be sure that Talib declares only 5 to Kambalik.
Yet something has been achieved. The Khan wanted to turn these fields into grazing for his horses. Someone was able to convince him to change his mind. Give me time to look around, to gather evidence. Then I can ask the Khan to help you.
You're not one of us. You come from another land. And your admiration for the Khan may blind you.
That is enough, Wandru. From the moment he entered my house, he was no longer a stranger.
You have good reason for hope. The South is a rich country, rich in the fruits of the earth, and also in wise men, whose fame has spread throughout China. I've heard people talk in Kambalik of strange men who live in the hills here. Men who have withdrawn from the world so they can live close to nature and understand her secrets.
You are speaking of the immortals, the followers of Tao, the way to true wisdom.
They are as inaccessible as the mountains themselves.
I've heard tell how these immortals live to great ages, and how their hair and teeth grow new each spring like leaves or grass.
I see that you wish to meet them.
Is that possible?
To climb to where they are is to peer into an abyss. My father told me once of a woodcutter who came across two old men playing checkers on a mountainside. The woodcutter was fascinated and stayed to watch until the game was over. When he eventually got back to his village, he'd no longer recognized his house or the people in it. Centuries had passed while he watched.
I will take you up into the hills. Perhaps it will make you understand our land and our people better.
When could we go?
It would have to be tomorrow. I'm going away for a while.
You'll miss the festival, won't you?
But you and your uncle are welcome to join us as my guests.